I'm Katie Whitehead. I'm an assistant professor of chemical engineering, and I have a courtesy appointment in biomedical engineering here at Carnegie Mellon. My lab's interested in drug delivery in general, and so what that means is that we're interested in coming up with ways that we can deliver drugs and other types of therapeutics into patients' bodies in a way that's good for the patient and convenient for the patient without causing any kind of harm or toxicity, and also getting the drug to the right location within the body, to the right organ target. So what we're trying to do is to try to come up with a way of packaging our drugs to help them evade the immune system to get to the right areas within the body. We're specifically interested in developing the chemistry for different types of drug delivery systems. So in one case, we're interested in developing oral drug delivery systems. So in this case, typically any kind of protein or peptide type of drug needs to be injected. So any kind of vaccine you're going to get, it's typically administered intramuscularly. Diabetics are a great example of people who have to take injections sometimes 3 or 4 times a day, depending on the state of their disease. This is really tough on patients, and it results in a lot of non-compliance issues, which can also result in long-term complications for people with these types of diseases. It would be fantastic if we could come up with some kind of a delivery system to take these types of protein drugs and to package them in a way that we can ingest them and take them orally. The problem is that our body is designed to break down proteins. Proteins are what we eat in food and in meat, and our body's excellent at having our gastrointestinal tract just chomp up those pieces of protein. And so when the protein is no longer intact, it's not going to have its therapeutic effect in the body. So insulin, you know, that we would take orally, it would typically just be degraded and it couldn't do its job. So what we're interested in doing is trying to develop what we call nanoparticles. So they're very small spheres, basically, that can encapsulate certain types of drugs and to deliver them across the intestinal wall into the bloodstream, where they can be absorbed into the systemic circulation, which is the full circulation within the body, and go to the right kind of target. We're involved in many stages of the process within my own lab. So when it comes to developing a drug delivery system, what we actually start with is the chemistry. And so the chemistry is the first thing that needs to be done, which can take anywhere from a couple months to a year. And then we start studying the way our chemical delivery systems are interfacing with the biological substances. So we do a bit of cell culture. And by the time you would have your work move to animal studies and hopefully eventually human studies, it might be on the order of several years by the time we could move things into clinical trials. So there's a lot that has to be done along the way, but my hope is that we can have an effect sooner than later.